Don't use that, Michelle.
Hi, my name is Michelle Lafiera, and I tell stories about people, places, and things. And the topic of today's video is flying trapeze. Flying trapeze was invented in 1859 by a man named Jules Leotard. He's also credited for inventing the leotard. Jules first got the idea when he was just 18 years old. There was a swimming pool in his father's gym, and one day Jules decided to hang a bar from the ropes that hung from air vents above the pool. History doesn't say how many times he fell into the swimming pool, but that same year he performed the tricks in Paris without any water or a net below. Today, trapeze is taught and performed with a net because people have gotten smarter since the 1860s, but they haven't gotten any less daring. This elegant and extreme sport on Long Island, and was surprised to find that classes were open to the public. And that summer, I also met this guy. This is Marco Rosamelia, and he's one of the owners of IFLY Trapeze.
I am telling you, in the first class, 9 out of 10 people will get their legs on the bar and do a catch with one of our instructors.
Trapeze. Take days, months, you can learn a trick and it can work out well, and then the next day or the next week your trick has regressed and you don't know why.
Ideally, I'm working on the layout. I'm working on that quite a bit.
You know, when you're trying to learn a new trick, the coaching here, they really just invest in you. They want to see you achieve your goals, and that just makes it all the more fun because you feel like you've done it together.
A lot of times people come here and try this once and don't even realize what they're capable of. If they get good instruction and they can translate that instruction to their movement and maybe even emotionally to letting go and freeing their mind up a little bit, they actually accomplish more than they think, even if that is just get your legs on the bar, get your hands on the bar, and do a catch.